Hello children, welcome to this online class of EVS. Children, in our previous video, we have learned what is crop and its different kinds. So, in today's class, we are going to learn various agricultural practices, that is, various steps of farming, means how to grow a crop. Farming is a step-by-step process. But today we are going to learn first three steps of farming only. That is preparation of soil, sowing seeds, adding manures and fertilizers. Children, what do you think the most important requirement of agriculture? Soil, that's right. But you know, soil needs to be prepared for crop production. Yes, soil is usually found solidified into hard chunks of soil mass. This soil needs to be softened and loosened before cultivation. Again, the question comes that why did soil needs to be loosened before cultivation? The answer is simple. Loose soil will allow more air to pass through the roots of plants. This will in turn aid the growth of the plant, leading to good crop production. Children, do you know that earthworms are known as friends of farmers? Let me tell you why they are known so. As earthworms help in loosening of soil naturally, thus helps in soil aeration. See how important is air, not only for animals but also for plants. So here are some advantages of loosening of soil, like it helps in more air passage, thus leads to good crop production. It also helps to hold water. And the last one, it helps in bringing up the nutrients up, or nutrients are brought up. Now I am going to tell you how. This process of loosening and softening the soil is known as plowing or tilling. Now the question comes, how is tilling or plowing done by a man, or how it helps in loosening the soil? Have you heard the name of the equipment called plow? Plow is a equipment used for loosening of soil, and it also helps in bringing up the nutrients up, or mixing the nutrients equally in all the layers of soil. So here are few equipments used for plowing, like cultivator, plow, hoe, harrow and spade. Now come to the next step after plowing, and that is sowing seeds. This is again a very important step. Once the soil bed is prepared, the seeds should be sown properly, like at proper distance, so that each and every seed should get proper air, sunlight, water and nutrients. Proper distance between seeds is very important, as if they are grown at one place, then there could be fight or competition for air, sunlight, etc. And in that case, only few seeds turn to plants, hence leads to less crop production. Next is, seeds should be sown at proper depth also. If they are sown so deeply, then it will hard for a baby plant to come out. And if they are sown superficially or at surface, then might be birds or animals pick them and eat them. And again, seeds will not turn to plants. So, good quality of seeds should be sown at proper distance and at proper depth. Earlier, sowing of seeds done manually means by manpower. But nowadays, for sowing large field, farmer use a machine known as seed drill with tractor. Children, sometimes your mama gives you some supplements like Bonvita, Pediasure, Complan, etc., etc. with your routine diet, so that you will grow better. You are not going to lack in any nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, etc. Similarly, for better growth of crop, we are supposed to add manures. Manure is also known as gobar khad. It is made up of all natural biodegradable substances. Biodegradable substances you have learnt in class 3 also. These are decomposable substances like cow dung, vegetable and fruit peels, dry leaves, etc. It increases the fertility of soil and hence increase the yield. Yield means amount or quantity of crop. Sometimes there is deficiency of only one type of nutrient in soil. In that case, in spite of adding all nutrients, we add that specific nutrient. For example, if the soil is deficient in calcium, then add only that. This we can do with fertilizers. Fertilizers are chemicals made in factories and specific in particular nutrient. For example, if you have deficiency of calcium, doctors prescribed you calcium tablets along with milk. So, adding manures and fertilizers help in boost up the growth of crop and also help in high yield of crop. So, in this class, we have done 3 steps of farming, that is plowing, sowing seeds and adding manures and fertilizers. So, today we have done first 3 steps of farming. That is, we have prepared the soil for our seeds. Then we have sown our seeds at proper distance and proper depth. And in last, for the better growth of our crop, we add manures and fertilizers. Rest of the steps we will do in our next class. So, this topic is continue to next class. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.